Palermo, my love. Let's go for it. Let's sail from Palma de Mallorca, 500 miles over the open sea to Palermo. Join us for a fantastic sailing trip to a marvelous town. Sailing from Mallorca to Sicily and back means 2 times 500 nautical miles over the open sea. In our case, with the Bavaria 151, a 15-meter boat with 5 double cabins, ideal for sailing with crews between 5 and 7 persons. Our crew, nicely European, 2 Spanish, 2 Germans, 1 Dutch, and a German skipper. The weather forecast. Weather can be tricky late October in the Mediterranean Sea. In our case, it was 2 days calm. After 2 days, a storm over 50 knots blowing directly from Sicily in our direction, so no way to go against it. Our only chance to achieve our goal to go to Palermo and back was to start immediately in the evening and reaching after 2 days the southeast coast of Sardinia, stopping there and waiting the storm calming down. Bad surprise in the morning. Our radar antenna was hanging down. This is a dangerous situation. In the best case, it falls down in the sea or on deck, but can also destroy a sail or even worse, can hit a person. So no way, we had to take it down. The 4 bolts were already lost, so we were very lucky that the antenna didn't fall down during the night.
The last bolt holding.
Having solved this problem, back to normal board routine. With an exciting interruption, we catch the fish. In this case, a bonito, which is not so delicious, but nevertheless a welcome enrichment for the board kitchen. Our second morning on the sea, no wind, no waves and sunny, so time for some exercises and time to stop to have a swim in. Stopping at the open sea for a swim, looking beyond and seeing nothing else than the endless big blue. This is always amazing and fascinating. After the swimming, crew is hungry, it's the ideal point to start preparing your lunch.
What is on the menu today?
Ratatouille, potatoes from the oven,
Third morning, not too early, arrived at a small harbor, Calasetta, in a small island, Sant'Angiocchio, southeast of Sardinia. Looking at the waves which were produced in the small harbor basin, you can imagine what's going on outside the open sea. Waiting until the storm calms down, having a nice walk through Calasetta. Enjoying swimming from a beach in a nice bay. And after 2 days, going ahead to Palermo. One more time a fish, this time again a tuna, but a bigger one and a real delicious one, a red tuna. Approach to Palermo. First, sailing through the industrial part of the harbor. Going to a small marina directly near the old town of Palermo. The old town of Palermo is an amazing mixture of rotten houses, renovated houses, small pubs, bars, restaurants, handcraft shops, market stands, hipster bars. It is a unique and fantastic place to enjoy colorful city life in a surprisingly non-aggressive atmosphere. Doing a kicker competition against the locals was a really hard challenge. Finally, relaxing, listening to some nice instrumental jazz music in a local pub. The famous Teatro Massimo di Palermo. It has also been used as a scenery for the movie Godfather 3. After 2 days, we had to go back to Palma de Mallorca. 2 days is much too short for Palermo, but nevertheless, our tough time schedule didn't give us another chance. After 4 days sailing, arriving at Cabrera. Cabrera is a small natural reserve island south of the east end of Mallorca. Ach, Cabrera is such an enjoyable place. It's calm, empty at least in spring and autumn, and sailing at the Baleares, coming from all these crowded places to Cabrera, is like taking a deep breath and getting calm. In our case, not so calm, because in the evening, laying there on a buoy in the Bay of Cabrera, what can we do? We party, because this was our last night together. So, nice cooking together, talking, discussions about cooking.
Cesar, are you really from Spain?
About the persons on board.
Are you really born in Mocha?
No.
Where are you born?
In Jeva, where the beer is from.
Ah,
yeah. Jeva. Here's the Jeva poorhouse.
Cooking is a serious task. And eating the fifth time tuna, which has been frozen, is also a hard task. Opening a bag of tortellini can also be a difficult challenge. With the progress of the evening and the emptying of some bottles, the cooks become more and more exciting, and the cultural side program becomes more and more amazing.
We put this nice metal campanello. So please try to.
And all in all, a good chance to finish the leftovers. Drinking and food. Next day. Ideal weather conditions to sail. 20 to 30 knots, half wind. Perfect to go back to Palma. Nice weather, nice waves, 1 to 2 meters. A fantastic sailing day. Waves and sun. Exciting end of our beautiful trip.